Today we are going to discuss about adverbs. Particularly, I'm going to talk about two adverbs which are very, very near to me. Yes, dear friends, these two adverbs are actually very favorite of Shiksha Mantra, of myself. But why these two adverbs are so very dear to me? It's because their position. Let me introduce these two adverbs first. The first of them is enough. Yes, dear friends, it's really very tricky when we use them, and obviously there's another, that's only. So today in our discussion of the adverbials, we are going to discuss about the typical placements of enough and only. So let's begin our discussion now. Yes, dear friends, enough. Normally, what we find, whenever we place an adverb with an adjective or another adverb, most of the time we place them before the adjective or the adverb. So as an example, you may say it is very cold today. It's very cold today. So very, this is an adverb which we have placed before cold, which the adverb is modifying. But when we talk of enough, this enough has something more than this. It's not placed before the adjective or the adverb it's modifying, rather it is placed after it. How? Yes, dear friends, this is the sentence, he spoke loud enough. Now my consideration is this particular word enough. When you talk of enough, this is an adverb and there is no confusion, it's an adverb. And what does it modify? It modifies loud. Now normally what we get, if we say he spoke very loudly, he spoke very loud, there won't be any confusion because we have placed very before loud, before it's before the word it's modifying. But here when we talk of enough, it's placed after loud, which it's modifying. So this is the special case. When we use enough, we place it after the adjective or the adverb it modifies. So this is our first point of discussion regarding enough. Now we'll discuss about only, where we place only. Suppose we take this sentence. Just consider this sentence. He has slept only 3 hours. So only. Where we have placed it? We have placed only right before the adjective it's qualifying, and that is 3. So only is modifying 3, and we have placed only just before it. So he has slept only 3 hours. He has slept only 3 hours. But it's all about written English. Yes, dear friends, when we have written it, normally such sentences goes with only getting placed right before the adverb or the adjective it's qualifying. But what happens when it comes to spoken English? There we may produce the same sentence but in a different way. So let us have the sentence first. So yes, dear friends, this is the sentence. He has only slept 3 hours. And here we have placed only, not before 3, but it has been shifted before the verb. The verb has been split up by only, and it takes place in the middle of it. And here you have to remember that it's all about spoken English. It's in spoken form. But will there be a change in meaning if we use only in such a way? So that's the question. We have to learn this, whether there would be any change in sense. But believe me, dear friends, there won't be any change in sense if you produce the sentence properly with proper intonation, because English is a stress language, as we know. So managing the stress in English is very, very important. If we say he has only slept 3 hours, it would be manageable. Have you followed it? I'm repeating it. He has only slept 3 hours. 3 hours. So I have emphasized the word three when I'm producing this sentence in speech. And it's a clear indication that three, that's our goal. Only is placed for three. Only is used here for emphasizing three only. So we may put an inverted comma here. We may put it into quotation. He has only slept 3 hours. So three is the most important factor. And in spoken English, we can use only by breaking the normal course of its uses, of its position. But it would mean the same if it's properly pronounced. I am repeating it, if it's properly pronounced. But there's a but again. If you make a mistake in making a proper emphasization, in putting the stress, if you produce the sentence, he has only slept 3 hours, that won't mean it. It would be different. So you have to remember another very, very important point for English grammar. English is not all for writing. It's for speaking as well. After all, a language is for speaking and not for writing. Writing comes later. First, it's for communication through speeches, speaking form. And there, you have to be very particular when you are producing a sentence regarding its stresses. And this stress, this emphasization is very vital. And if you follow it properly, obviously, you are going to make a better English, a better pronunciation, a better understanding of your sentences for the others, because your goal is, after all, with a language, nothing but communicate. So our communication will continue, but before another communication, we have to take a break in the form of a fresh discussion. We are returning very soon. Until then, bye bye. Happy learning.